So what is a scar? Right? We all hear about scars, we think about a scar, and we basically just think about what we can see, that you know, mark on our face or on our chest or on our legs, a cut from a surgery, right? But the truth is, what you see on the top is just the beginning, it's just the surface. Now, every scar you see is not necessarily a problem, okay? But more often than not, it does relate to issues, because that little scar that you're seeing on the surface is actually the tip of the iceberg. Right? You ever see that picture where you see the very tip of the iceberg and then they show you underneath and it's like spread to like beyond gigantic size? Well, that's what can happen with scars within your body. The scar tissue can spread. It causes your tissue to stick together instead of allowing it to slip and slide and move the way it's supposed to move. And it cannot just go right where it is. Most of the time, like we'll take a C-section for example, when you feel that scar, right? Actually, the scar itself on that surface, that top layer, that actually moves, doesn't seem to be a problem. But if you reach down a little bit below or a little bit above, all of a sudden you feel that thick, kind of ropey, kind of stuck area within your abdomen and your pelvis. Well, that's actually the scar tissue, because what most people don't even realize is that two things. One, scar tissue can spread. It doesn't just stay right underneath that incision line that you see, or where you have that road rash from where you fell off your bike doing some type of extreme sport or your motorcycle. Basically, the scar tissue can get stuck and end up spreading throughout your body three-dimensionally. Very common with C-sections is you can have scar tissue that sticks down into your flexor muscles or down towards your pubic bone, which is limiting your ability for your hip and your pelvis to move, pulling you down in the front. It can go straight three-dimensionally all the way to your back, attached to the muscles and the bones in the back of your sacrum and your spine, or it can even travel all the way up into your diaphragm, making it hard for you to breathe, hard for you to fully extend, and you're totally unaware of that was actually causing and happening with all the actual cause of what your pain and your issues are, because you're healed, you're done, the scar, you're past the surgery, the kids are grown, it can't be affecting me now. Not true, it can be. Anytime you have an alteration in your tissue, in the connective tissue that holds you together, you're gonna have a problem at some point in time, if not immediately, but down in the future, somewhere in your body. Can give you another really crazy example. Let's say someone has breast augmentation. You believe it or not, that pull from having the scars and from the augmentation, you can end up with problems in your feet. That's right, one end to the other. Your tissue is one big piece, and any kind of disruption, kink, or problem within that tissue is gonna cause an issue, not necessarily where the scar is, but somewhere else throughout your body.